Hey guys, this is Rob here. We're here to talk about fuel injectors today. Today I'm joined by my colleague Matt, and we get a lot of calls on fuel injectors, problems and questions about fuel injectors. And Matt, what are some of the most common questions that you get on the fuel injectors?
Yeah, absolutely, Rob. We get tons of calls on injectors, all sorts of engines, all sorts of sizes, every single day. The most common question that I get, Rob, is that, hey, why are my injectors failing?
So the injector can fail a couple different ways. It can fail electronically, whether it's the solenoid on the top of the injector. All these injectors, for the most part, are going to be some sort of electronic control, aside from the ISX, which is a mechanical injector. But failure can happen a couple different ways with the electrical failure. It can also happen mechanically. So the injector is still mechanical on the inside, and it's susceptible to debris, to water, to contamination. So contamination is usually what we see with the injectors failing. You know, you could have something that's just plain wore out too. You got a million miles on it. High pressure inside the injector has caused clearances to expand, and maybe you got more leakage in it than you ever had before. So there's multiple ways that an injector can fail.
Now, Rob, we have five different injectors here. Can you just break down each one individually for us?
Absolutely, absolutely. So what we have here is, like we talked about earlier, the HEUI injector. This is going to be for the earlier Navistar engines that run the HEUI system, DT-466s, 530s, 570s. This is going to be the newer G2.9 HEUI injector. That one is going to be for some of the newer Navistar engines. Very similar injector to what you would find in your 6-liter Ford Power Stroke. This one here is going to be the 14-liter Detroit injector. That one is going to be on like the 14-liter EGR engines. We go over here to this mechanical injector. It's the only one of the bunch that doesn't have an electronic solenoid on it because it's on the side of the engine. This is a mechanical ISX injector for your Cummins ISX engines. This one here is going to be your 10R1000 going in the Caterpillar C15, electronically controlled, actuated by the rocker lever run off the camshaft on that one. So some of our more popular injectors here on the table today.
Now, Rob, let's just say I'm doing an in-frame overhaul kit. We're getting all new parts in this engine. Is there any kind of benefit to getting new injectors into my engine?
Well, I tell you what, one of the things to keep in mind is these injectors have very tight tolerances in them, and over time, just normal wear and tear, those tolerances will increase ever so slowly. Probably not something that you're gonna even notice, because it's easy to compensate for when you're driving down the road. Your foot just goes a little bit further into the gas pedal, right?
Yeah.
So you still have the same power, you're just pushing a little bit further. And over 800,000 or a million miles, you don't notice that you're pushing a little bit further, a little bit further, a little bit further. Maybe your fuel mileage is going away. So one of the things to keep in mind is when these injectors are wearing, the tips where the fuel sprays out has little tiny holes, and over time those holes get bigger and bigger and bigger. What happens is the fuel doesn't atomize as well, so instead of getting that fine mist of fuel in there, maybe you're getting droplets, and the droplets don't burn as good as the fine mist of fuel, so your foot goes to the floor a little bit more. So when you replace the injectors and everything is tightened up and the tolerances are good and it's flowing with the pressure that it's supposed to, now you're going to be off the gas pedal a little bit to make the same power, getting better fuel economy. So absolutely a good idea to freshen up your injectors when you're doing your engine. Hopefully bring some of that fuel mileage back, some of that power back that you used to have.
You know, Rob, I get questions all the times on HEUI injectors. Now, how does a HEUI injector differ from a regular injector, and what's the difference with it?
So the HEUI injector is commonly used on maybe your Fords, your Navistars, and some of your Caterpillar engines use a HEUI system, which is a hydraulic electric unit injector. Essentially, those systems are taking engine oil and running it to a hydraulic pump, and that hydraulic pump is creating high pressure to actuate that injector. That's what's actually forcing the fuel out of the injector versus, say, an ISX where you got a push rod that's a rocker lever is pushing that injector down, creating the pressure. The hydraulic pump will create the pressure on these. This is like your standard DT-466 injector. What I'm going to say is the old style. And then your G2.9, the new style HEUI injector. Those are both electronically controlled for timing. When it's going to actuate, but the hydraulic pressure is what's going to actually force the fuel into the combustion chamber. That's a HEUI injector.
Gotcha. So Rob, just from what I can tell, we get customer questions all day about injectors. Now, what's the difference between maybe a new and a reman option? And especially if it is reman, customers are going to have a core. What dignifies a good returnable core at Highway and Heavy Parts?
Gotcha. So first of all, new versus remanufactured. It's pretty rare to see a brand new injector. The price of a brand new injector is through the roof if it's even available. So that's why that it's a viable option to rebuild these or remanufacture these injectors. They can go through and put the parts in them that are needed to make them perform as if they were a new injector for a fraction of the cost. So very rarely do we see a new option. And then as far as cores go, obviously, the injector has to be the same injector. If I sell you a HEUI injector, you can't return an ISX injector and expect a good core,
sure.
Right? So we want a HEUI core back if we sell you a HEUI injector. We want an ISX core back if we sell you an ISX injector. Some of the injectors, they need to be part number specific. So if I sell you a 10R1000, I need a 10R1000 back. You know, other basics of the cores, you know, it can't have broken terminals, whether that's a side terminal on a 14 liter, whether it's a terminal on the top of a 10R1000, or it's a terminal on a HEUI injector. It can't have broken terminals, can't have broken springs, and it can't have a smashed tip. So those are the three main things that you see with the fuel injectors that you want to make sure that, hey, if you got a smashed tip, let's plan for paying a core. If it's got a broken spring, plan for paying a core. But in most cases, if you've got a running engine and you're taking a set of injectors out, that's probably 99% that you're going to get a good core because it was a running injector when you took it out. You haven't disassembled it, taken it apart. So that's going to explain the core criteria on most of these injectors. And of course, when we send you a set of injectors, we also send you a prepaid label to send them cores back. Just put them back in the original boxes, box them up. We try and make it as simple as possible for that core return. So if you need injectors or you just got questions on your injectors, give us a shout at 844-447-1453, or then get us on the website, right, Matt?
Yep, our website is www.highwayandheavyparts.com.
From diagnosis through delivery, we're Highway and Heavy Parts.